Dry pedicures are the future of pedicuring. This is Erica, and I'm going to show you how to use an e-file to reduce calluses and to clean up cuticles. We'll also relieve his ingrown toenail. And the first thing that we're going to do, since we're not using water, is we're going to use at least 70% alcohol to kill a majority of the pathogens on the foot. I'm making sure that I'm spraying both the top and the bottom, in between the toes, and just letting that absorb into the skin. This is also going to help with the odor, so anytime during the service if the feet start to smell, I would just go right to my alcohol bottle and respray them. Another option as well is to use warm soapy towels to wipe down the feet. My next step is I'm going to use a callus softener, not remover. The reason I like products like Alprosan is because I want to use a urea-based product that breaks down the skin cells, and using something that's acid that needs to be neutralized. That way the body's only absorbing what it needs. Next, I'm using the 12mm Boss Lady Nail Nippers. What I really like about these is that they have that straight cutting edge with a sharp point. That way I can really lift up the nail plate to make sure that I'm not cutting the skin. And all you're gonna do is short little baby nips to cut the toenails. The key to successful toenail cutting is to making sure that the toenail is not cut under the skin to help prevent any ingrowns. And then I'll do my shaping with a diamond file. What I love about our Lady Diamond files is that they're made with 100% real diamond. So what that means is you're going to have that nice sharp cutting edge without applying force, and it's going to be very comfortable for your client. They're not going to feel those particles on the throwaway disposable files that are usually really gritty and too abrasive for the toenails. So when your client is getting a pedicure, they're literally feeling their toenail being pulled because of the abrasive tool, which is really nice, especially for your clients with thinner toenails. I'm using the medium grit Lady Diamond file here. The medium is great for gel as well as for toenails. If you have clients with thicker toenails, you might want to step up to a more abrasive file, which would be our coarse, which is usually used for thick toenails or for acrylic. When we're using our diamond file to shape the toenails, we want to make sure they're straight across. They can have a little bit of arch, and we want to make sure we have those rounded corners to make sure that the toenail isn't growing down into the skin. Now that our toenails are nicely shaped, we're going to grab our Lady Boss Safety Pusher. What I like about our pusher is that it is safety because of this rounded edge. It has two different sizes depending on the nail plate. I'm using the smaller side right now, and what I'm just doing with my pusher is I'm just gently pushing back the cuticle to release those dead skin cells from the nail plate. That way I can ensure that I'm not overfiling the natural nail when I go to use my diamond bits. It just helps create that pocket so we're able to tuck back our polish or our gel. Now to select my diamond bit, we have the tapered barrels, and then we also have the unicorn bits. Today, I'm going to use the medium unicorn. All right, so here with my Journey e-file, I'm going to run my e-file at 8,000 RPMs in the forward direction. I'm going to start on the small pinky toe, and at a parallel position, I am just removing the dead skin cells off of the nail plate. I'm doing a few very, very gentle passes, just like you're petting a kitten. This is not something that's very aggressive. We're just letting the sharp tools do the work for us. Now, these are diamond tools. So diamond is a scratching action. So we're just literally exfoliating that dead tissue off of the nail plate so that we can apply new product. Very, very gentle. We're always working parallel. After I've done a few passes, then I'm going to take my rounded unicorn point and just gently push it into the epimicium area to also exfoliate that dead skin as well. I like working with the unicorn bit on the toes for several purposes. The one is because it's a larger cuticle bit, so I get more longevity out of it. Also, it has a rounded point and not a sharp point, so I can get into some of those hard to reach areas without the fear of accidentally puncturing the skin, something I want to be very cautious about, especially on the feet. And as you can see, I'm still working in that parallel position from right to left, removing those dead skin cells off the nail plate. Once I've successfully done that, I'm just using that rounded point and gently exfoliating that epimicium area. And that taper point allows me to get into some of those hard to reach places, but I'm making sure I'm never sticking my bit in between the lateral fold. We never want a blind file, so taking a little bit of alcohol on a fingernail brush to remove that dust is really helpful as I'm getting ready to switch my e-file from the forward direction to the reverse direction. But I want to make sure I can still see what is attached to the nail plate. The only way to do this is to remove the dust. I'm going to take my e-file and turn the forward onto reverse. Still running at 8,000 RPMs, and with the same tool, the unicorn bit, what I'm doing is I'm running my machine in the opposite direction in which my bit is turning. What this is going to allow me to do is to open up the cuticle even more, creating that really defined, deep look, and also helping me open up the nail plate more so that I can make sure I have removed all of that dead cuticle. Depending on what your preference is, you can use the unicorn in either medium or fine. If you have somebody that has thicker cuticle, I would recommend doing medium. If you have somebody who it has thinner skin, the fine. Or if you're new to e-filing, the fine would also be a great approach in the unicorn or any of our pedicure bits. That way, as you're learning the techniques and angle of how to handle your tool, we're not over-filing that natural nail plate. One of the benefits of using a diamond bit is that we can also prep the nail for a product application. So if we were going to do gel polish on this client, what I would just do on all these toenails is drop my barrel down and lightly go back and forth and take off that shine, so I will have already prepped my nail for that product application. If I'm not able to remove all of the dead skin around the nail that I want to with my unicorn bit, that's when I'll grab our Boss Lady nippers and just do a little bit of cutting, especially around the free edge of the toenail sometimes. As you can see right here, it can be a little harder to reach with the barrel, because what I don't want to do is take my barrel in a vertical position and just start to swipe it through the nail groove and to distort that track the nail needs to grow out on. So I would rather err on the side of caution and just use my nippers and cut that additional skin, and then go through with my refining ball at 10,000 RPMs and smooth that area up. You can use nippers. I prefer using the refining ball around the cuticle area because I think it creates a more softer look. Also, since we're not soaking in water, the skin's not as soft, which is also nice because it also ensures that we're not going to overfile. So at that 10,000 RPMs, the refining ball, I've chosen to use fine on this client because my client doesn't have very thick cuticles. So I want to make sure I'm working with a tool that aligns with his or her type of skin. If I had a client who had really thick cuticles, then I would choose to use my medium. With the refining ball, I'm removing the dead cuticle as well as polishing and softening that edge. So any area that I also use my nippers on as well. Oh, and isn't that just satisfying? I'm going to work in both directions, but any area that I was working with my nippers, I'm going to be sure I hit just to smooth out, so as the skin grows out, I'm smoothing it out. Also, if you have callus at the free edge of the nail, especially on those runners or those who do impact sports, just softening those, but we want to make sure we don't remove those unless our client requests it. So we're running our e-file in the reverse direction. That's also why when I'm working from left to right, I want to go opposite in which my bit is rotating. So right now when I want to work from right to left, I need to be on top of the nail. And that way, we're not just pushing down the cuticle area that's been lifted off the nail plate, but we're actually exfoliating it off. Be sure whenever you're working with the ball bit that you are not running it on the nail plate. This is strictly for the skin, and I'm working in a motion in little circular motions, which is called skirting. I'm thinning down the cuticle area here instead of using my nippers. This is going to create just a more refined look for my client, and it's also going to reduce any hangnails. Always going against the grain. That way we're not pushing the skin down, but we're making sure we're exfoliating it. And since it's dry, it's just flaking right off. This is why it's extremely important to make sure that you're protecting yourself eye protection, some kind of mask, and smock as these particles are going airborne. Sometimes on the smaller toes, it's really helpful to be able to get your hand in there and just to pull back the skin. If the skin starts to feel wet, we want to make sure we spray it with alcohol because this is a dry process. The drier the skin is in the area, the easier it'll be for the bit to grab a hold of that skin and pull it off. So those with hyperhidrosis or wet skin, this will be a little more difficult process, but you might be surprised at what you can achieve with these bits. So I definitely say it's worth trying, and if your foot is getting too wet, use that alcohol. Next, we're going to use cuticle oil. We're going to put a little bit on each toenail, and then we're going to do our callus work. The benefits of this is if I'm going to do a polish service, is that I'm not going to wait around for my client's polish to dry to put oil and accidentally smudge it. So right now I'm just working with the Boss Lady Pusher, pushing that oil and softening that area while I do the callus work. To do a majority of my callus reduction, I'm going to use a diamond coarse pedicure skin bit between 20 and 30,000 RPMs, just depending on how thick the callus is. As you can see, I'm holding my e-file differently, holding it more like a potato peeler as I shave away the dead skin cells. I'm using my thumb as a fulcrum finger just to support me and to stabilize while I'm filing the client's foot. I'm working in a downward position. And I'm also making sure I'm in a controlled area. So at any time, if my client says they're feeling any discomfort, I know exactly which area to stay away from. When you're working with pedicure bits, I recommend starting off with diamond bits because that is an exfoliation. So we're not literally cutting using blades into the skin. We're just gradually shaving off those dead skin cells that the product is helping to release. If you have a client who has really thick callus, I recommend spraying the foot again just in the calloused area. You can start your service right away. It can be a little bit wet, or it can also be dry. The product's going to continue to work. What you will find is that your bit starts to load up. I recommend having that fingernail brush with alcohol next to you. That way, when it does, just as you saw me grab my brush, I just ran the bit over that fingernail brush to help remove and to release any of just the oils and products and debris that was in my bit that was just creating friction. For a more detailed pedicure, you can go back to using the unicorn bit. This is the same bit that we used on the toenails that I'm now using just to open up and to free some of that dead skin cells in between the fissures. This is not necessary, it's just one of those added benefits that I wanted to show you guys. And what's nice about this is when we release those dead skin cells, when our client uses their moisturizing lotion, it just helps penetrate into the skin better as we have eliminated that dead skin. So I'm going to spray a little bit of soapy water just so you guys can see with all the dust removed before I put on the mousse of how nice and smooth this looks without any lotions or products on the heel. Very smooth, very comfortable for our client, never putting them in a position where they're going to be finding discomfort after our service. Now I'm going to use my Alprasan mousse, which will be back in stock soon under a different name called Poto Expert. So stay tuned when I will do more videos about why I love this product, but it's unavailable right now. However, my personal stash, I love this product. It's good and safe on diabetics. It's FDA approved, and it does not leave the feet feeling greasy. So having a waterless system reduces bacteria. So bacteria can lead to infections and just potential problems in cleanliness for your salon. A waterless approach to doing pedicures also gives clients a longer lasting pedicure. So one of our last steps before polish is using the Boss Lady Rasp. I only use this on clients who are more prone to ingrown toenails or feel like they have pressure in between their lateral fold and their nail plate. So what I'm doing with the rasp is I'm making sure with the smooth side is in, between the soft, tissuey, fluffy part of the skin and the teethy part are going into the nail plate. And what I'm doing is I'm just filing that edge of the nail because it's deeper into the skin that I'm not able to get in with a hand file, and making sure I'm rounding off those corners so my client doesn't have the potential for an ingrown. So when ingrowns start to grow down into the skin, that can often happen from improper cutting, their shoe preference, and also just their anatomy. So what I'm doing to help eliminate that pressure is I'm only pulling, I'm not going in both directions. As you can see, I'm working in one direction and just smoothing the corners of that nail. Harder to do with a hand file. So anything that looks like it just needs to be a little rounded, I'm just gonna take my rasp. And this is a better alternative too for your clients. If there's someone that's prone to get in there and to start cutting, is to sell them a rasp so that they can actually just take those sharp corners and give themselves relief by smoothing the corners versus cutting into it and leaving a nail spike. Earlier I put some cuticle oil on the nail plate that now I want to remove before I apply my product. So I'm just going to take some acetone, remove any oil from the nail plate, and then I'm going to apply my gel polish or nail polish, and we're all finished.